Before these healing walks started, a lot of us didn't realize that the Bay Area is the second largest cluster of refineries in the entire nation. And so what that means is that we're the ones breathing that air. Our children are the ones breathing that air. You know, that's why so many of us know people with asthma.
It's really raising that awareness about the oil refineries here in our own backyard.
Refinery Corridor Healing Walks are an enactment of this really beautiful vision to bring different communities together, to pray for clean air, clean water, clean soil for all of the different people that live in the Bay Area.
So that's 16 walks over a period of 4 years, and today, as you know, is 16 of 16.
Isabella, I'm Northern Cheyenne and River Rat, Muskogee Creek. I'm 23 years old and I live in Richmond, California, just about 20 blocks from here. I'm one of the youngest members of I Don't Know More SF Bay. I'm also one of the treaty signers of the Indigenous Women of the Americas Defending Mother Earth Treaty. And I helped organize the Refinery Healing Walks for this year.
It's such an honor to see everyone here, to see what it's like to live in a refinery town.
I deal with the Chevron refinery every single day.
A lot of the communities that live near the refineries in those fence line communities are communities of color, you know, poor people and Indigenous people.
These towns that these refineries are in, are called sacrifice zones. This is an Indigenous issue. We don't need to take the oil out of the ground. It's important for the oil to stay in the ground. And, you know, we don't need this profit. We don't need this capitalism.
We know that the Refinery Corridor Healing Walks are connected to issues and struggles of keeping fossil fuels in the ground all around the world. Today, our guest, Gloria Oshigo Santi from the Sapara Nation in the Amazon, is actually from a community where their territories are divided into blocks of oil that can be sold off or auctioned off to different countries to come into the Amazon and to drill out oil from the most biodiverse regions of the entire world. The Amazon provides a fifth of the air that everybody breathes, and if you drilled the most biodiverse part of the Amazon, it would only provide oil for the world for a couple of days. Most of the oil that is drilled out of the Amazon actually comes to California and is driven in our cars and in our fleets. And so the refineries that are here in the Bay Area, the refineries that are here in California, are processing the oil that's coming from all of these places around the world where really horrible destruction is occurring.
I'm really happy to be here with you all, and with you all supporting me, with you all by my side.
Governor Jerry Brown allowed the fracking industry to put fracked water, poisoned water, into over 500 aquifers that were federally set aside for human consumption.
Every time that I walk these healing walks, I always pray that the people in the community recognize how much power that we have as people to do something, to demand that changes be made, to show up to city council meetings, to demand better regulations, to demand better. We deserve better than this, and I just can't wait for more and more people to begin to realize the power that they have.
We know that there's answers out there, and we know that we are capable as human beings, as people power, we're capable of moving towards those renewable energies.